Hello, Facebook, YouTube. Topic of the message is talking about the reality that God has, you know, gave me a more, I believe, a sound, more sound revelation of take, you know, Matthew's 20, I think, 6 and 27, 28 or something like that. You know, it's talking about taking the yoke and learning of me. But this is a more sound revelation to that. And the topic of this message is the reality of learn of me, you know, learn of me, keep learning and learning and learning of Jesus. Pretty much not me, but Jesus. Keep learning and learning and learning of Jesus. See, here's the thing that is supposed to be the ideal of the situation is what really I'm proposing to you, that the ideal is, you know, everybody's complaining why things are so hard, why things are so, you know, why do I got so many burdens, you know? Or Christian says, I'm a Christian, then I have a lot of burdens, you know what I'm saying? And my burdens are tough, my burdens are difficult. I hear those complaints a lot, and I complain too. You know, I'm not, you know, exempt to that ideal. I complain too, certain things are hard and difficult to me, but the thing is, what Jesus is basically saying for eyes to have ears and ears to hear is to take of his yoke and learn of him. Now, he says, but when you learn on his yoke is easy and his burdens are light. And the problem is people don't understand that, you know, but it says the key thing is learn of him. That's the whole supposed to be the main idea. You know, learn of him. We learn how to learn of him. Our yoke becomes easy. The things that we once can do are difficult. And, you know, they become light. And the thing is, a lot of people, you're facing a lot of difficulty. Why? Are they facing a lot of difficulty because they are what, less of a Christian, or, you know, more like a Christian, or what? What's the reason why you're facing a lot of difficulty? Well, it's just simply plain and well put that means you got more learning to do. You know what I'm saying? The ideal is saying that because you are facing difficulty, you have more learning to do. That I try to tell people about, period. You know what I'm saying? Being a Christian is supposed to be about learning, 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 and learning. You really don't stop learning. But when you stop learning, you become a fool. A fool will stop learning. And that's what, you know, happens. People stop learning because I think it is because the way the, you know, church system is taught and people been teaching different aspects of the Word of God in different ways, and people haven't interpreted the way of the teaching and how it works. You know, people get confused, and it's like this love is this and joy is that and this is faith, and, you know, people got all kind of books on faith, all kind of books on this and all kind of things out there that people don't have a sense of understanding how simple it is to really truly be a Christian. But the problem is people got all these, like I said, they got all these books out there. But the problem is, really always will be, is what is not going on. That is the problem, what's going on in Christianity, is like I tell people, the fellowship is not going on a major scale the way it's supposed to be in a church based upon Acts 2:42. You know, fellowship is supposed to be play a great role, you know what I'm saying, than anything. Not these conferences and not these revivals and not these camp meetings and not all this. Fellowship is supposed to play a major role in the development of the true church. And of course, the church is operating in division, you know what I'm saying, and operating, and God, Jesus said, if any kingdom divided against itself shall not stand, shall be brought to desolation. So therefore, this church system, no matter how many books they give you, that you're going to find yourself, you know, facing difficulty within the church system because the church system is not operated correctly. And they can throw you any kind of book. And that book can be telling the truth about how to make you become a better Christian. But if you don't address the wrong that is going on, you know, there, you're not going to find out how difficult, why you're not progressing as a Christian the way you know that you're capable of progression. But that is another message itself. That's something that you're supposed to learn, you know. But if you continually operate in a system that is not producing the results that it's supposed to produce concerning the Word of God, and just, you know, because it's good for you, you're learning to become more Christian, but everybody else is not learning as much as they need to, it's really a recipe of disaster. But that's pretty much the tale of the tape of the Christian world we live in right now. That's why there's a lot of lukewarms than more real Christians, because nobody's not addressing the truth. But that's another message still. But at the same time, we are supposed to be learning a simple pattern, a simple way to live life, a simple way. It's like, you know, Paul says, how can, in 2 Corinthians and 11, how can, you know, you make difficult this, I'm just paraphrasing, it's not exactly, but he's saying that how can you make something difficult, a simplicity of Christ? Christ is simple. Christ is supposed to be simple. He's not supposed to be so complicated that I see it here, how he's being presented and talked about to men and women of God that y'all go to the conferences and get blown away and how they're so, you know, whatever. But it's a simplicity. He's simple. It's a very simple ideal of following. If you follow it according to the instructions, you will get the result that you're getting. But you're supposed to be learning the Word of God by your walk and by others that you see walk and by really fellowship and really understand, first of all, this is a team effort. Like, being a true Christian requires people around you, requires a circle of believers, not you going alone by yourself. But it requires a circle of believers to surround yourself by that is encouraging you to, you know, go to faith, glory to glory. You're not supposed to be a Christian by yourself. And the thing is, what people need to understand is it takes a team work. You know, God, if you study the church, it's nothing but a team. It's one body, many members. You know what I'm saying? One team, many, you know, football players. You know, there's no, you know, individuals supposed to be considered out there. But the thing is, we need to understand that this is what's supposed to be learning. We're supposed to be learning and seeing of finding a simplistic idea of doing Christianity. And the thing is, that's what I'm all about, giving y'all a simple idea that you're supposed to see and just stay committed to get the results that you're supposed to produce to truly be on fire for God, to keep seeking, be pressing towards the mark of the higher calling of God in Christ Jesus. In Philippians 3 and 14 is what I'm aiming for you to be about, wanting to do. And it just requires learning. And the more you get the simple things, God can show you the deeper things and stuff. Hello, how you doing? And you will make sense of a whole lot of stuff that is going on around you that is difficult for others to see, but you to see things in a simple way. And the thing is, it's all about learning and learning and learning and learning. And if you get the learning and learning, you will start understanding what you're supposed to do and what you're supposed to perform. All right, that's the message. I hope you got it to copy. Glory to you, Reverend Evan, Jesus' name, amen. Hello. Hey,